Assalamu alaikum. In today's lecture, we shall talk about mathematical modeling of pneumatic control systems. Pneumatic control systems and hydraulic systems, these are similar to electronic amplifiers. Electronic amplifiers amplify electrical signals, that is the voltage, whereas these pneumatic and hydraulic systems amplify mechanical systems, that is force. And therefore, these pneumatic and hydraulic systems can be utilized to lift heavy weights or compress some objects. We shall not go into too much detail of pneumatic control systems. We shall only take one representative example, and that is the pneumatic control systems available at Control System Design Lab in PIAS. This system consists of a cylinder. Inside this cylinder, pressurized air can enter from two paths, and there is a piston, not visible over here, there is a piston in this cylinder which can move either towards left or towards right. This piston is not visible over here. Let's see the schematic diagram of this system. It is shown over here. There is a cylinder inside which a piston can move towards left or towards right. Pressurized air, which forced to enter by a compressor, enters in from this tube, splits into two parts, and then enters into the cylinder from this side as well as from this side. There is a nozzle, and air can also escape through this nozzle. This nozzle is shown here in this system, and the escape from this nozzle depends upon the flapper, position of the flapper. Flapper is some strip of iron shown over here, which can be moved towards left or towards right by application of some force on it. So the air which escapes through this nozzle or through this nozzle depends upon the position of this flapper. We want to obtain mathematical model for this pneumatic control systems system, and that is demonstrated on the next slide. Here is the same pneumatic control system. The linear displacement of this piston is theta naught. Here I have used the same notation as that in the manual of this system. Otherwise, we were previously using x to demonstrate the linear displacements. So do not confuse it. It is linear displacement of this piston. Pressurized air is entering from this tube and then enters into this cylinder. This rate of this pressurized air is denoted by Q, and the escape rate of the air is denoted by Q naught. The this strip flapper, the magnified version is shown over here. Here is a flapper which can be moved towards right or towards left, and this displacement of the flapper, this end, is denoted by X. Here the opening of this nozzle depends upon the movement of flapper at this position. So movement of this flapper at this position is denoted by Y. We can see that if this displacement X, or in other words displacement Y, is larger, there will be less escape of air from this nozzle and more air will enter into this cylinder. That is, this Q is proportional to displacement Y. More is the displacement, more air will enter into this cylinder. This K is the proportionality constant. Then by applying the mass balance equation, A is the cross-sectional area of this cylinder, A multiplied by delta theta naught. Delta theta naught is the small change in the position of this piston. So differential change in volume is equal to the inflow rate multiplied by differential time. This K into Y is the inflow rate. For a very small time, this equation can be converted into a differential equation, which is written over here. this equation can be further rearranged to write it in this way, that is d theta by dt is equal to k over y, k over a multiplied by y. K is a constant, a is also a constant, so let's name this constant as capital K. So d theta by dt is capital K into y. The equation can be written in Laplace domain. So Laplace transform of d theta by dt with initial conditions set equal to 0 is s into theta of s, and the right hand side of this equation is k into y of s. The equation can be rearranged to obtain a transfer function between this linear displacement theta naught, this is also theta naught, this is also theta naught, theta naught of s divided by y of s equal to k over s. So this equation is the mathematical model for pneumatic control system.